Hey guys, what is up? Josh Ford here from Edit Video Faster, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to export a video with an alpha channel so that you can bring this video into another program or even back into After Effects. So to show you, I have this comp open, and this is my podcast logo, and I just have it spinning around, and it loops at the end. This comp is 3 seconds long, and as you can see, I have the transparency toggled on. So you know that this is going to be transparent. And so this is all just like in the export settings, really. So once you have your comp set up so that you have your animation or whatever it is, you know, video on top of a transparent layer, you want to go up to composition, go to add to render queue, and then go down here and find where it says lossless. This will probably be the default that pops up for you. But under output module, click on the setting here. Then what you need to do, you need to find, well, first, make sure the format is set to QuickTime. This is how you get a video exported with an alpha channel. Alternatively, you can do a Photoshop sequence or a TIFF sequence and put an alpha channel on that as well. But that's going to spit out a whole bunch of files. Just depends on how you want to work. Most people want to keep it simple. They do a QuickTime. And the QuickTime is just going to give you one file. And then the important step here, under Video Output, find Channels. And under this dropdown, select RGB plus Alpha. Click it. And then click OK, and then export to, you'll select, you'll click on that, decide where you want your video to go, click save, and you can rename it as well there, and then go ahead and click render. This might take a bit if it's super complicated, and being a QuickTime movie with an alpha channel, it might spit out a really large file size. I mean, we're talking, you know, maybe hundreds of gigabytes, just depending on, you know, how long it is. You know, if we're doing something that's, you know, 5, 10, 15 minutes long with an alpha channel, you're going to get a huge file, so just be prepared for that. But if it's something like this, quick, you know, 3 seconds long, not complicated, it should be pretty small. So I'm just going to bring that back, that thing I exported into After Effects just to show you what it was. This was the file, and this was 11 meg, so really tiny for a QuickTime. So let's open it up, and then just go back to my comp. So you can see, you know, this spinning on the background. Turn that off, turn this off, and let's just bring that comp, or that QuickTime movie with the alpha channel into our comp, just so you can see that it looks the same. Here it is. With the alpha channel, you still see that transparency, and we have our looping logo here, and I can turn that off, turn the actual logo in the comp back on, just so you can see, yeah, this is the same thing. So that's it, guys. That's how to export a video with an alpha channel in After Effects, so you can bring it into another program or back into After Effects. One last time, be prepared. File sizes might be huge. So just look out for that. Make sure you have room on your hard drives. Make sure you're not, you know, spitting this out necessarily to your desktop, especially if you're doing a Photoshop sequence or a TIFF sequence, because you're going to get a file for each frame of video when you do that, unless you put it into a subfolder. But that's a completely, well, not completely different topic, but different topic than what we're focused on right here. So hope you found this helpful. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up. Helps other people see this video. And if you want to see more videos by me, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you'll get notified when I come out with a new video. And that's it. All right. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.